Far from frivolous, fashion design is a complex combination of material science, high technology, and environmental sustainability problems. I'm Dr. Mark Liu, a fashion designer, and I explore the underlying scientific principles behind fashion design and the fashion industry. So what I look at is fashion pattern making, the way that clothing is made from these linear measurements. So imagine you're being fitted for a piece of clothing, and they take perfect linear measurements, but when the garment comes back, it never quite fits perfectly. And this is a really big problem because it affects our entire industry, everything from your self-esteem to multi-million dollar fashion empires which are built online and are failing because they're getting too many garments returned. This was a really big deal, and I asked the question, why can't we just get the fitting of the garments right the first time? And to do this, I had to go to a place where fashion designers feared to tread, the mathematics department. What I found was that fashion designers were using the geometry of flat surfaces or Euclidean geometry on the fashion designs, but since the 18th century, there's non-Euclidean geometry, the geometry of curved surfaces, which has completely different rules. Now, fashion designers were using the wrong geometry on the wrong surface, and this was creating this systemic problem. You'll find that different parts of the body have completely different geometric rules, and this is why fashion designers had to come in and use their judgment and personal experience to fix all these problems. Now, I saw this problem as an opportunity to develop an entirely new fashion system based on non-Euclidean geometry. And the reason why we had to do this was because fashion designers just didn't see non-Euclidean geometry, and scientists, engineers, and mathematicians just really didn't know how to make clothing that well. So we came up with something completely different. And what I was searching for was a device that I could actually use to measure the curvature of the body, because linear measurements by themselves, without knowing the curvature of a surface, they're not very useful for anything. So in collaboration with Rio, I commercialized this device called the drape measure. It's like a tape measure. The tape measure measures linear measurements, but the drape measure actually can be put on the body and takes the curvature, interprets it into a measurement that fashion designers can use. Now, when I teach my classes in fashion pattern making, a lot of it is skill, and making it easy for them to understand an experience and a craft that takes many years to develop. But now we can radically simplify how fashion pattern making is done. And this can enhance creativity, but it can also reduce the amount of time that is spent in prototyping garments and has a real world saving. Now, as a byproduct of my research, I found it was actually possible to teach advanced mathematics such as calculus and limits through fashion design by teaching children how to make the clothing. So we start out by making little paper models, and while they're making, we discuss calculus and limits and the geometry that goes into fashion. We then get them to make the models. They use some colorful paper sometimes to give it some different effects, and then we take a photo. So they use mathematics to actually learn, and then use that learning to have more creative freedom. So the better you are at the mathematics, the more creativity you can express. So what do I do now? As a Chancellor's Postdoc Research Fellow, I try to sort of spread around and get as much interdisciplinary collaboration with fashion as possible. So in my own research, I spend my time working on 3D algorithms that can hopefully take better, can create garments from 3D scans of the body and develop new pattern making techniques. I collaborate with people such as the Deep Green Biotech Hub, and we're trying to see if it would be possible to actually build all the materials from fashion just using algae instead of petroleum-based substances. In engineering, I look at different ways that we can use wearable technology in fashion. In the business faculty, I look at sustainability and how this circular economy could possibly work with different high-tech materials in fashion. There's also the area of 3D printing. If you think about how can we take all that we have learned from hundreds of years of traditional fashion making and bring it to this high-tech technology such as 3D printing where all the rules are being broken. So I hope you can see that it is possible for fashion to be greater than just catwalks, and we can advance fashion far beyond the catwalk. Thank you.